Tippit is organised so that many of the customisations and behavioural changes on the phone are controlled from the cloud,
right,
not from the handset.
So what's a good example of that?
Well, speed dial buttons.
Okay.
Okay, so let's suppose that you have a number that you ring very regularly,
mm-hmm,
and as a result, you'd like to have it on one of the line keys on the side, what are often referred to as programmable line keys,
mm-hmm,
and you'd like to be able to just press the line key and have the phone call set. The way that it works is that the administrator, so in this case the customer enterprise administrator or the customer group administrator,
mm-hmm,
for the site concerned,
yep,
will go into the Tippit administration portal and use a technique known as tags,
right,
to make changes to the configuration of the handsets. Now these tags can be applied in order to override the default behavior of the phone.
Mm-hmm.
They're also referred to as custom tags.
Right.
And what happens is that the administrator uses the portal to configure tags that change specific behaviours, then rebuilds the configuration files for the phone, and then can either allow the user to reset the phone and pull the configuration down,
mm-hmm,
or there is a technique available as well using a hyperlink in the portal to cause the phones to reset immediately, or immediately they're idle if they're already in a call. Right, so we've jumped into the portal already having selected the group or site that we're interested in,
mm-hmm,
because all of the tags that you change will generally occur for an entire site for a handset type,
yep,
or for an individual user at a site,
right,
for a handset type. And you'll notice I keep saying handset type, not handset.
Yes.
Now, the reason for that is that if a user, for example, at a site had multiple different types of handsets, then you would have to make the same change for every one of them,
mm-hmm,
because they have their own different types of configuration files.
Mm-hmm.
So in this example here, I'm going to show you first how you get in to set a tag for an entire site for,
okay,
one handset type. So you can see here I've gone to the utilities menu for that particular site, and I've gone to device configuration, and that lists the different devices that it knows about at the site at this point in time.
Right.
So you can see here, there's the Cisco 88X5 multi-platform phone with DMS support. In other words, it's supported by Tippit DMS.
Yes.
So that's the one we need to change. So I'll simply click on that, and I can go in there and you can see we have three tabs: files, custom tags, and tag set. The one we're interested in here is custom tags. So I go in here and I can see that there are already some tags that have been set for all phones of this type at this site,
mm-hmm,
such as which codec to use by default,
yep,
G722. And Tippit state is a system specific tag that tells the phone how to find the SBCs for Tippit. So in other words, where it connects to in Tippit to make a phone call.
Okay.
Okay. Right. Now, if I wanted to add a tag, I can simply click on add, mm-hmm, and I will get a box popping up that tells me that I can now add an individual tag by name and its value. Now, a word of warning, tag names are extremely precise.
Right.
For example, I can have all the spelling look right, but if I make some basic error like using an underscore instead of a hyphen,
yep,
or vice versa, it can cause the tag to fail.
Okay.
And an example of what would happen then is that when I try to rebuild the files and reset the phones, well, basically no behavior changes.
It's not going to work. Yeah.
And
yeah,
as a result, I know that I have an issue, so I might have to go back. So that's the way to change all the tags in a one handset type,
yep,
at one site.
And if there are multiple handsets at a site, I need to do it for each type of handset.
That's right.
Yep.
And that was that list that we,
sure,
saw a moment,
okay,
ago. Here they are again,
yep,
just to remind us. Now, in my case, I want to change it for one, or imagine that I want to change it for one user.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll click on your particular user ID.
Mm-hmm.
And the path now into your individual set of custom tags is slightly different. I start at the profile area here, you can see. I click on addresses.
Mm-hmm.
I then go across to configure identity profile.
Yep.
Or device profile, pardon me. And it will then bring up five individual areas rather than,
sure,
three, or five individual tabs rather than three. Here's custom tags again.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see at this stage, there are no custom tags for,
right,
you. So what I would do is the same process again. I would add one if I want to. There's where I put the tag name in, and that's where I put the tag value. I click OK, and when I come back out, you would see it listed here. At that point, all I've done is say to Tippett, I would like to add a tag to this handset type for this site or this user.
Right.
Now, to actually force it to apply, I need to go to the Files tab, click on Rebuild the Files, which will gather up all of the tags and change the configuration, the default files.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can click on Reset the Phones. And if the phones are idle, they will begin to check their config, notice they need a new config file, pull it down, and possibly reset.
Right. So likely that an administrator would probably do this after hours to be safe.
Possibly, although the fact that they won't reboot during a phone call is a safe bet as far as not interrupting communication.
Yeah.
That is one way to look at it. But if you were doing an entire site and one set and the handset types across one site and you have lots of them,
yeah,
it could have the effect of taking a lot of users out at once.
Sure. You said how important the tag names were. Where do I find those?
Telstra publishes configuration guides for Tippett for different types of handsets that show the individual tags' names and the values and ranges of allowed values that they can individually hold.
Yep.
Now, a couple of words or additional words of warning there. Sometimes you have to set multiple tags at once to change a behaviour.
Okay.
All right, so that's number one. Number two, and I made this point earlier, make sure you are very precise in observing how the syntax of these tags, particularly the names and the values, look, because if you get the name or the value wrong, then it just won't work and it might not be clear why. Probably the key message out of this is if the user makes changes like speed dials, they can do so using the button menu that you have on the phone itself. But next time the configuration is changed through the portal by the administrator or there's a new firmware or whatever the case, if there's a change to the phone's fundamental software, all those speed dials, if you've had several of them, they'll disappear again.